Today we're going to be comparing the Rocket Appartamento Neuro versus the Flare 58. But before we do that, I just want to thank you for tuning in to Cabin's Coffee Corner. This channel is designed to help you choose the coffee equipment you want to brew with at home. There's a lot of options out there, so I'm hoping to narrow down for you and help you make the decision that you want to make so you'll be satisfied with your purchase. I have an Instagram account called Cabin's Coffee Corner. You're more than welcome to follow me there. And also, please like and subscribe. I'm pushing out a lot of content here, and I would love for you to stay tuned with what's going on here. Also, I do want to note that this rocket was sent to me by Espresso Outlet and Joe at Espresso Outlet for in exchange for a review. So basically what that means is he lent me this machine. I review it for a month. I pulled about 50 shots on it. And then I ship it off to the customer who buys it as an open box item at a slight discount. So this was not necessarily sponsored, but it was given to me in exchange for a review from Joe. However, I do have full say to say whatever I want on this machine. I don't have to necessarily review it positively. So that's kind of how that is, but disclosure, and Joe hasn't seen this, and I'm getting full freedom to say what I want to say on it. So a couple things on this. This is an $1,800 machine. You can get it without the metal cup rail and without the black on the side for about $1,750, I believe. This is ranging at, I believe, $580, give or take now. The price has changed and fluctuated a bit over the time since I've bought it. This is a heat exchanger machine, which means you can brew and steam at the same time. This is a manual lever machine, which means you can't steam with it at all. But you can manually control all the brew with it. So a couple things. This comes with two portafilters. It comes with the double spouted portafilter and single spouted portafilter, some cleaning products, and a stainless steel tamper, as well as, of course, the machine. The Flare comes with a pressure gauge here on the side, a wooden bottomless portafilter, which means that it has no spouts on the bottom of it, and you can kind of see your extraction as it comes out on the machine. It also comes with a stainless steel tamper as well. I believe they changed the finish of it to glassy instead of this matte finish, which if they did, kudos for them, because that is my least favorite thing about this Flare is the finish of this tamper. It just feels super uncomfortable. It feels like a chalkboard. It also has this little drip tray here on it. So these are huge on different machines. One of them is three times the price as the other. One smaller, all this other stuff. So I want to go over a few key features of both and why you'd want to choose one over the other one. One, this heats up all the water on its own. It has a boiler in this, and it allows you to brew and steam at the same time, meaning that you can pull your shot and brew with the steam wand here at the same time. This has a no-burn steam on, which means it doesn't burn and you can touch it. However, it still does get warm and a little hot, but it's not too hot where you feel like you can't move it on its own. It has a drip tray here, which is a nice feature. It's a great machine, great entry-level heat exchanger machines, comes with a decent tamper. I prefer this tamper over the Flare, mainly because of the finish. I prefer the fit in the basket of the Flares versus this one, but that's a whole another conversation. So this one is basically, if you like milk drinks, this is kind of the way to go because you can heat up milk and steam milk with it. This is an all-manual machine, which means you basically have to heat up the machine. It's got this little button, and it plugs in on the back, which heats this up to the temperature. It takes about 10 minutes, while this takes about 30 minutes. So you're at a third of the time with this already. However, you do need a separate source of water, which means you have to have a kettle to heat it up. This is the Stag EKG Plus, which is a Bluetooth kettle I can turn it on and set the temperature of. So I have to boil water with this, and then I have to pour it in the top of this Flare here. Then I pull up the lever on there, and that allows the water to go inside the chamber here, and then you press down and it pushes it through the portafilter into your cup that's placed below. With that, after you're done with your shot, you have to pull up the Flare again and push through the water before you remove the portafilter out, because if you remove this portafilter before you do that second pass through of water, what happens is your water in, like, water coffee stuff spills all over the place because there's still some water in this group head. There's not a ton, but there's still a little left over. So you do have that through. This one you have to kind of let the water drip through before to clean the brew head, and then after at the end of your shot, you have to do the same thing again where you let water go through again after the porter filter just to rinse this off a little bit. But I feel like that is a little bit easier than the flare on that regards because you don't have to have that separate cup. It goes straight into the drip tray. One of the main things that you get with this flare that you do not get with the Rocket is full control. And what I mean by full control is with this, you grind your beans, you put 18 grams in or whatever your dose is, and then you pull this lever and you let it go through. That's the control that you get with the Rocket. You can't change the pressure that you're putting on through. You can't do a slow ramp up in pressure. You can't do the pre-infusion that you want to do, things like that. Versus the flare, I can brew an entire shot at 2 bars of pressure if I wanted to. Why would you want to? I have no idea. But I can control and I can start at 2 bars of pressure. I can pre-infuse for 10 seconds, 15 seconds, and then I can ramp it up to 6 bars, to 9 bars, to 12 bars, whatever I want to do, and then I can ease it off as much as I want to, and I have full control over the outcome of the results in my cup. One of the reasons that that is nice, and why that's a huge feature on this one versus that one, is because say you grind a little too fine, you can adjust your pressure on there to still get a drinkable shot, versus this one you're kind of just out of luck on. Or same with if you grind too coarse, you can adjust your pressure in order to get a new shot and compensate for the lack of grind size that you did. So this is a little bit more forgiving and you can get the most out of your bag of coffee instead of wasting them. So I pulled shots side by side with these machines and I used Archetypes Home Blend, which is a local coffee shop. That's how I do all my testing, is on that bag of coffee, solely for the fact that I'm familiar with it and I've drank it a lot over the years, so I wanted something consistent for all of my testing. And when I did side-by-side testing, the flare hands down won, which is kind of a crazy thing for the fact that the flare is 3 times less than the Rocket. Even if you add the $200 kettle with Bluetooth feature on there, you're still at less than half the cost of the Rocket. Even if you add this thing over here, which this is the Bellman steamer, which basically allows you to steam milk for the flare. It's not as great as the steam one on the Rocket. I think the Rocket gives you better results, but this gives you enough to make latte art there. You add that and you add a grinder like the Niche Zero, you're coming in about the same price as that. So you can get a full setup with this versus that. So with that being said, why would you even choose the Rocket to begin with if I just told you you can do exactly what the Rocket does, except have more control with your flare than the Rocket, and buy the grinder and everything you need? Why would you choose the Rocket then over that? And the main answer to that is convenience. It is very nice to brew and steam at the same time. It is more hands-off than the flare. While it takes about the same time to brew from bean to cup, minus the heat-up time, one of the things about the Rocket is you lift up that lever, you brew, and you just let it come out until you get the desired yield that you want, versus the flare, you have to hold and control the pressure the entire time, which, if I'm honest, I prefer not to control the lever, to be honest. It seems this is easier to do in the morning, even though this doesn't take as much time, even though this is still really convenient to do in the morning. It seems like this is easier and more user-friendly than the flare. Because with the flare, you have all these things that you have to worry about, like preheating this, making sure your water is up to temp, and then you have to worry about your pressure and pulling down on the lever. However, that is really easy to do. I feel like this is easier in my user experience. So if you have a multi-family household and you just want something that's easy and convenient, that's going to give you a great latte or a great shot of espresso in the morning, then this is the way to go. If I was more of a milk drinker, in other words, if I drank more lattes, if I drank more flat whites, cappuccinos, cortados, whatever it would be, which I drink a good fair amount of, I would choose this machine because of that milk feature, and it's less finicky than the thing like the Bellman and the Flair that gives you more control over everything. I think it would just be simpler in that. However, if you're aiming for just the best espresso you can get, I would look other than the Rocket Apartamento, and I would go toward the Flair because that gives you the control that you want to get. Like you're not getting this feature of manual control that you get on the Flair on machines under a couple $1,000s. That's just not a feature in there. At some point, I plan on reviewing some of those features on like things like the Lip Bianca and the flow control that you get there, and comparing that with the Flair, and we'll see what that looks like down the road. But overall, that's kind of my opinion on it. This seems very clustered when you're steaming on things like that, but that's what you get at this price point and this form factor. It's pretty small and it fits on the counter pretty well. They didn't skimp on quality on this thing. Everything feels good. Everything looks good on this machine. And I've been quite happy with the aesthetics of it. A couple nice features is this heats up your cups for you. And if you want the best quality you can, when you put hot liquid into a room temp cup, it instantly drops the temperature of the shot of espresso. So when you have your cup heated up, you're going to get a better shot than you would if you put it into a straight room temperature cup. So you have to preheat your cup with the Flair, and you can just simply put your cups on top of this and they get nice temperature for brewing with, and it's been a quite pleasant experience in that mind. I've enjoyed using this every morning, but a few mornings I have missed my Flair. I had my Flair sitting on a shelf above this thing while I used it over the past month, and occasionally I'd pull down the Flair and compare some shots. But there are moments where I missed using the Flair, but I guarantee when I send this back, I will have moments when I'm missing the convenience of this. So these are two completely different machines, and they're very hard to compare. But if you're looking for the best quality you can get, the best shots you can get, the Flair is no comparison on the quality of coffee that you're going to get. If you're looking for convenience, the Rocket is the way to go. And again, like I said, you can pick up things like the Bellman and the Kettle to make your experience a little bit better and give you basically everything that the Rocket can do, you can do on the Flair with those features for quite the less price. So there's a couple of hacks that I want to give you for each of these machines that I believe that will change your experience on these machines substantially. Like I said, there's a huge heat up time with this. This one's 10 minutes is what they recommend to heat up the cylinder here. And this one is 30 minutes. Both of those, I don't find the enjoyment of going over to the counter and clicking this button three times for it to heat up and then waiting 10 minutes and then coming back and brewing a shot later. Same with this one, waiting 30 minutes and coming back and brewing a shot later. So with the Rocket, what I did was I bought a smart plug. This is what a smart plug is. So basically, you have your plug here, you plug it into this, and then you plug this into the wall. And what that does is basically means you just leave this button here up on your machine. So when you plug in your machine, or up on your machine, so it's basically always on here, but the light will not turn green when it's on. You have to turn on this plug. There's a little button here so you can turn it off on and off manually if you have an outlet on your countertop, say like right here. But I have this drop down on a coffee bar down on the wall, so I can actually use my phone to manually turn on this machine. So if I'm in the bedroom of my house, I can turn it on from there. If I'm at work and I'm coming home over lunch, I can turn it on from work so it's heated up as soon as I come home from lunch so I can pull a shot there. So I can do all of this through my phone, I can do all of this through my Apple Watch, and I can do all of this through Siri. So if you don't have those features, if you don't have Siri or things like that, and you just need another convenient way, you can buy an Amazon Alexa for like $25, or probably even cheaper than that if you go on Facebook Marketplace and buy the first gen, which basically just means, say, hey, Alexa, turn on my espresso machine, and it will turn it on for you, and then when you're done pulling a shot, say, hey, Alexa, turn it off, and then you're good to go on that feature. Saves a ton of time, allows you to heat it up. I heat it up from my bedroom, from my phone, and then I go get ready for the day, and then I'm out there and my espresso machine is ready to go to pull a shot, and then I head to work. With the Flair, there is another thing kind of similar to that, but it is slightly different. There's this thing called the SwitchBot. And the nice thing about the SwitchBot is if you have a kettle like the Stag EKG and you didn't opt for the Bluetooth feature, which was another $50, you can use the SwitchBot for this as well. So the SwitchBot is, because it's a little slightly different and you don't have the switch like this machine does, you need something to push a button for you remotely. This one is Bluetooth censored, so I cannot control it from work or anything like that, but it does heat up quicker, so it's a little bit better. You can set timers on it, so you can have it turn on automatically at, say, 7 o'clock in the morning. You can do that with both the smart plug and both the SwitchBot. So the SwitchBot is this automatic button pusher here. It sticks on to this Flare preheat button, and this little thing comes over and it pushes the button. And it pushes the button 3 times in the sequence that I need it to turn it on, so this is fully heated with it. With